Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are doing well. So, continuing with the last class of our alternative English, let's start our today's class. All right. So, as we completed two chapters of our syllabus, all right, one from the poem, all right, that is one from the poetry section and the other is from the prose section. We completed the first poem, The Daffodils, and the second part. That is the first prose of the prose section, that is The Suitor and Papa. I hope those two chapters are clear to you all. Now, for today's class, moving back to the poetry section, we shall continue with the second poem of our poetry section, that is When Autumn Came by Faiz Ahmed Faiz. All right. Now, when we hear the title of this poem, that is When Autumn Came. So we come to know that here the poet refers to the autumn season, right? And what are the scenarios, normally that we tend to see during the autumn season, all right? What happens in the autumn season? So those things are being referred in this poem, all right? So now that is one aspect of the poem, all right? However, metaphorically, if we try to find out the symbolic meaning of this poem, it is all about human life. All right, so that will be the other aspect of the poem. The first aspect of the poem will be like whatever we experience, we see, all right, during the autumn season, all right, just as the title itself suggests, When Autumn Came. All right, so we definitely come to know about the things. The scenarios of the autumn season, whereas the other aspect of the poem is symbolically what it signifies. All right, so here autumn season is being compared with human life. Very important. All right, that is direct comparison is being made, you know, about between autumn season and human life. All right, so that will fall, the symbolic meaning of this poem. All right, the troubles, you know, the obstacles, the hardships that we face, you know, in our life. So those become the second aspect, that is the other aspect of this poem. All right, so that is the overview. So to say, that is the layout of the poem. Now, before proceeding further, here you are given some information about the poet. All right. So please let's go through about this and we will continue the poem afterwards. All right. See, Faiz Ahmed Faiz. He was born in the year 1911 and died in 1984. Please, my dear students, do remember the years, all right, when did the poet, you know, he was born and when did he die, all right? So these years you need to remember. All right, see, now he is known as a revolutionary Urdu lyric poet, all right? So Faiz Ahmed Faiz, you know, this poet is basically, he is famous, he is known as a revolutionary, you know, he was a Urdu lyric poet, all right? He belongs to Pakistan. All right, that is why it says he is an Urdu lyric poet. He has been widely translated into English and other languages. Whatever writings, you know, whatever poems, whatever other stories, you know, he has written, those things, the language, you know, has been translated into English and also other languages. Born in Sialkot, all right, he was born in Sialkot, that is in Pakistan. He lectured at Amritsar. He gave his valuable lectures, you know, at Amritsar too, that is in India. He participated in the Indian labor movement. He had given, you know, tremendous contribution, a huge contribution towards this movement, that is Indian labor movement. Later, after partition, he worked as an editor of the Pakistan Times. Now, Pakistan Times, as you must be knowing, that is name of a newspaper, all right, that is published in Pakistan. So there, for that newspaper, he even worked as an editor of that newspaper, all right. And his well-known poetic volumes include Lamentations and Fingers of Breeze. Now, when we come to know about his, well-known and famous poetic volumes, then Lamentations and Fingers of Breeze, these poetic volumes, this fall in the main category of his famous poems, all right. Definitely When Autumn Came is also there, one of them, all right. But Lamentations and Fingers of Breeze, you know, these are also considered to be his famous poetic volumes. Means in the volume, these are different poems, all right, that he has written. Now, he was also, you know, honored with various kinds of awards. As you know, we know that in India, in our country also, we have got very prestigious awards like Bharat Ratna, right, and many more such kind of awards. So in the similar way, all right, he was also honored with a very famous award, all right, that is known as Nishan-e-Imtiaz in their country, all right. So that also you do remember this. Alright, now coming to the poem, I'll go through the poem once, alright, I will read the poem once and then we will come to the explanation part, alright, see. So before starting the poem here, one just a general question which is kind of a pre-reading is given, just let's have a look at it, see what it says here. Look at this picture. Now as you will see here, a picture is given here, alright. Then you are asked a question that write down all the words and phrases that come to your mind as you look at it. Now, when you see this picture, what are the thoughts, all right? What are the things that come to your mind? You are asked to write it down. Compare your list with your partner's list and add items to your list. As we add items in our cart, isn't it? Isn't it so? Like in online shopping and all. So in the similar way, it is also asked here, right? You are also asked to compare whatever you have written, the points, and you are asked to compare with your partner's list, all right? And add the items to your list. And if you feel like adding some more items, you know, that your partner has noted down, so you can do that. Too. So this is basically for enhancing your speaking skill, so to say, or writing skill. All right, you can discuss this also with your friends whenever you get any kind of free time, right? And try to speak in English while conversing with your friends. Try to converse with with your friends in English so that it enhances your speaking skill. All right. So this is just a kind of general question. All right, that we will discuss later on. Alright, see. Now listen to the poem. Your teacher will read it aloud as usual. See. This is the way that autumn came to the trees. It stripped them down to the skin, left their ebony bodies naked. It shook out their hearts, the yellow leaves, scattered them over the ground. Anyone could trample them out of shape, undisturbed by a single moan of protest. The birds that herald dreams were exiled from their song, each voice torn out of its throat. They dropped into the dust even before the hunter strung his bow. Oh, God of mercy, God of May, have mercy. Bless these withered bodies with the passion of your resurrection. Make their dead veins flow with blood again. Give some tree the gift of green again. Let one bird sing. So this is the end right, of this poem, Faiz Ahmed Faiz, translated by Naomi Lazard. Alright. So, by going through the poem, I think you must have got some kind of idea, right? Whatever is being mentioned, whatever we come to know through this poem, like in the upper meaning, we can see and find that whatever scenes, whatever we see, right, in our surrounding during the autumn season, that is being mentioned here. All right, but literally, if we try to find out the symbolic meaning, then the poet here says that whatever troubles, whatever hardships, whatever obstacles we face in our life, we have to accept it gracefully and with a positive note. In a way, we can say the poet is urging, you know, he's requesting all of us not to break ourselves, not to break down, you know, in terms of, in case of any problem, any hard situation that comes into our life. Now, if we see in the present moment, what are we facing? I think all the people, you know, all over the world, you know, they are facing the same kind of hardship at the present time, same kind of difficult situation we are going through, you know, at the present time, that is the pandemic. Know that obviously all of us know about it. Alright, so now if we break down, you know, if people, if individuals break down at this point of time, then what will happen? There will be no use of living this life. Alright, so just with the hope, with positive thinking, and also with you know, kind of in taking it in a constructive way, you know, we are supposed to move ahead in our life, you know, each passing day. All right, and that way only, every people in this world, all right, they are doing the same way, they are doing the same thing, all right, just with a positive hope. And hope is such kind of thing that can make or break our day. All right, that is why generally or normally it is being said that always have a positive hope. All right, hope is always supposed to be in a positive sense only. All right, because no person, I think no person in this world, you know, wants to have any kind of negative thinking. All right, or no person in this world, you know, want to move ahead, you know, with some kind of negativity taking along with himself or herself. All right, so that is what it says here, that whatever troubles, whatever hardships, whatever obstacles come in our life, we should accept it, all right, in a constructive way and move ahead and lead our life. All right, so the figure of speech, that is the literary device that we see here, is the metaphor. All right, that is direct comparison is being made, you know, between autumn season and human life, right? So we can actually learn, you know, we can learn from nature, from our mother nature. We can learn from seasons, you know. Every year we see different kinds of seasons. You know, summer season comes, then again winter season comes, autumn season comes, spring season comes. So every season has got a particular, you know, period of time that it lasts for. All right, summer season lasts for a particular period of time. Similarly, autumn season, it also lasts for a particular period of time. So it's a kind of cyclic movement, you know, that happens every year, and we experience each and every season in our life, isn't it so? So in the same way, you know, we also go through different kinds of phases in our life. Suppose at one moment, if we face a bad moment, you know, a gloomy moment, then on the other hand, what happens? The good days will also come. So till then, what one needs to do? One just needs to have patience. All right? One just needs to have patience in order to go through and in order to overcome the difficult situation. All right, and good days will again come. All right, so with this hope, this poem has been written by this poet. All right, and I hope you must have got the, you know, symbolic meaning of this poem. All right, so for today, let's just stop here. All right, I did not able to start the poem anyways, but you have got the overview, that is the layout of the poem. So the explanation part we will do in our next class. All right, so till then, all of you, please take care, have a great day ahead, and thank you very much.